For this problem, we are going to make use of this simple data path that consists of a four-register register file, a relatively simple arithmetic logic unit that can perform add, subtract, multiply, and NAND operations. In addition, it can compare two inputs and determine whether or not they are equal. The result of the comparison, Z, can then be used to control what happens next. There are multiple control signals in this data path. The first two are A cell and B cell. These are used to select which register drives the corresponding multiplexer output. The value stored in the register selected by A cell becomes the A input to the arithmetic operations and is passed to the arithmetic units along the red wire. The value stored in the register selected by B cell becomes the B input to the arithmetic operations and is passed to the arithmetic units along the blue wire. The next control signal is op cell. It selects which of the four operation outputs should be selected by the op cell multiplexer as the result of our operation. This result is fed back to the register file along the purple wire. The WN is a write enable for the register file, which specifies whether or not the result of our operation should be written back into the register file. If it is supposed to be written back to the register file, then the W cell control signals select to which of the registers the result should be written. The yellow box is the control FSM. It generates the control signals for the rest of the data path based on the operations that you want to perform. Suppose the initial value of our four registers is R0 equals 1, R1 equals 0, R2 equals minus 1, and R3 equals n. We want to evaluate the result of the function 3 times n minus 2 and store the result into R3. Our job is to design the control FSM so that it produces the correct signals to achieve what we want. To help us get started, here is an incomplete listing of the code that will achieve what we want. The SX labels are the names of the states corresponding to each instruction in our program. Our first job is to figure out the values of RX, RY, and RZ so that our code behaves as expected. Let's begin by looking at state S0. We want to end up with a value minus 2 in R2 by adding R2, which currently holds minus 1, to some register. In order to produce minus 2, we need to add minus 1, which means that Rx equals R2. Next, we look at state S1. Here, we want to end up with a value 2 in R1 by adding Ry to R0, which currently holds a 1. In order to produce 2, we need to add 1, which means Ry equals R0. State S2 adds R0 to R1 and stores the result in R1. Since R0 still equals 1 and R1 equals 2, then we produce R1 equal to 3. Now let's look at state S3. Our goal is to multiply 3 times n and store the result into R3. To achieve this, we multiply Rz by R3 and store the result in R3. Since R3 currently equals n, that means that we want to multiply it by R1, which equals 3. So Rz equals R1. Finally, we add R3 and R2 to produce 3 times n minus 2 and store that result back into R3. S5 just executes a halt instruction to indicate that we are done. Now that we have working code, our next goal is to determine the settings for the control FSM that will make the correct operations be executed by our data path. Since we have 6 states, we will need 3 state bits to encode the value of the current and next state. We begin with state S0. In order to encode that we are in state 0 using 3 bits, we set our current state, S of 2 colon 0, to 0, 0, 0. In this operation, we don't care about the Z signal, so Z equals X, which means don't care. The instruction that we want to execute after this first add is the next add in state S1. This means that our next state is 0, 0, 1. Note that the notation S prime is often used to represent the next state. Our register select signals each need to select one of four registers. This means that these signals must each be 2 bits wide. Our A cell control signal identifies the register that should be used as input A. This register is R2, so A cell is 1, 0. B cell identifies the second source operand. In this case, it is also R2, so B cell equals 1, 0 as well. The op cell signal identifies which operation we want to perform. Since we have four distinct operations, we would need 2 bits to distinguish amongst them, and we would make each operation be associated with one of the four encodings. For simplicity, let's just label op cell as add to indicate that we selected the encoding for the add. The register we want to write our result to, also known as the destination register, is R2 for this operation. This means that W cell equals 1, 0 and WN equals 1. WN is a signal that enables writing to the register file. If it is set to 0, then regardless of the value of W cell, no value will be written into the register file. Now let's quickly run through the rest of our instructions. Our current state is state S1 or 001. Once again, Z is a don't care. Since the instruction that will be executed next is the one in S2, our next state is 010. Our A cell equals 00 and B cell equals 00. Op cell equals add and W cell equals 01 and WN equals 1. State 2 follows the same model. So current state is 010 and next state is 011. Here, A cell equals 00, B cell equals 01, and W cell equals 01, and WN equals 1. Once again, our op cell is an add. We move on to state 3, whose current state is 011, and next state is 100. A cell equals 01, B cell equals 11, W cell equals 11, and WN equals 1. Here, our op cell is multiply to indicate that the operation to be executed here is a multiply. For state 4, we have current state set to 100 and next state to 101. A cell equals 11, B cell equals 10, W cell equals 11, and WN equals 1. Our op cell is once again add. Finally, we reach state 5. This state looks a little different from the previous state, so let's examine it a little more closely. The first thing to note is that when we get to state 5, we want to stay there because we are done with our execution. So both the current state and the next state are 101. Most of the other control bits can be set to don't care, because at this point, we mostly don't care about what the rest of the data path is doing. The only other signal that we do need to worry about is WN. Since we're allowing the rest of our data path to run in whatever way, we need to ensure that nothing produced on the data path at this stage gets written back to any of the registers. In order to guarantee that, we set WN equal to 0. Here is the complete control ROM that will execute the function 3 times n minus 2 and store its result into R3.